Maria Guiwai and Mark Sumatra. She received her Bachelor of Arts at the University of the Philippines and completed her postgraduate status in Bachelor of Laws from the same university. At some point, she went to the United States to pursue her Master of Arts in International Relations degree at Boston University. She qualified for civil service professionally, passed the bar exam, and the Foreign Service Officer's Examination. She served in Home Office in different capacities, and her last assignment there before she came to Toronto was as Director of the Foreign Service Institute. Her qualifications and experiences are too numerous and too long to mention, but if I could leave them all, I am afraid that she might have the chance to speak for lack of time. So I'll confine myself to enumerating her Foreign Service credentials. Since 1973, under whom Minerva Jean Falcon has been a vice consul, acting administrative officer, consul, acting principal officer, deputy consul general, minister consular, and consul general in places like Paris, France, Sydney and Melbourne, Australia, Madrid, Spain, Honolulu, Hawaii, Hamburg, Germany, and Vancouver, British Columbia. She has been ambassador extraordinary and many potentially in Ankara, Turkey, Berlin, Germany, and Bern, Switzerland. And in February of this year, 2010, she took over as Consul General in Toronto. So my friends, ladies and gentlemen, let us give a very warm welcome to our inductee officer, our keynote speaker, and our new Philippine Consul General for Toronto, the Honorable Minerva Jean Falcon.
I I did also in that meeting, ACCC, this is that. And I have been attending all sorts of fundraisers. I understand it's a fundraiser also, and I congratulate you for all your efforts. I was meeting with the program, and I understand that you will do scholarships. There's one thing that is not dividing me also, and almost every weekend I've been attending something collected with them, and I don't know whether you're aware of the segment of our community, you know, our caregivers, and they're the more vulnerable part of our community. I know last Saturday there was a group that was giving them the tax seminar, tax meeting, and then there was something in Mount Zion Church somewhere, and it's like they're going like that, they get molested, and Minister Jason came there, and Pastor Brian was there. And twice already I have been attending something for them, to teach them what their rights are and all that, because these are people who need a lot of hand-holding. So that's how my life has been, and I'm sorry I had to come late, but I hope you understand. I love coming to organizations, functions like this. It's the only way I can find out what the pulse of the community is. And also because they're strong, my mandate is very strong, and I care deeply, because as ambassador, it was very clear by the end of instructions that I'm supposed to foster a sense of brotherhood and goodwill among Filipinos and inculcate in all of us a strong sense of community. And so far, I have been very encouraged by what I have seen. I know, like I said, I read about what your fundraising is all about. It has to do with scholarship. And I think, correct if I'm wrong, there's a orphanage. I can only congratulate you for what you are trying to do. I also tried quickly to find out about this term. Summer, I have been to that area, I have been to Leyte twice, and I have crossed over to Summer where they make beautiful mats. But more importantly, I went there in collection of the Panahiga males. We were at the entire group, the American Church was there. As head of Office of American Affairs, we were lobbying very hard for them to return, for the U.S. to return the males. But we have not been very successful. They want to give us some replica. They say a booty of wars. It's very important. But I had been there. There was a program which reenacted what we went for. And for that, I congratulate the people of Samar for being such clever guerrilleros and being such patriots. Congratulations, you come from a very significant part of the country. You know, people should know more about what we did there. I am not going to stay here for long because there's going to be another speech, but I want to remind you that leadership involves a lot of self-sacrifice. Easy to be a leader, especially of Filipinos. They're always talking about our brand mentality, and I don't believe in that. And you know, it's always good to try to uplift our community. I came from a Korean function tonight. I was invited by the UN Consul General, and I was very impressed because they put together Korean symphony orchestra. And they invited somebody from Europe to be the soloist. And I found out that these are composed of second generation Koreans who are actually integrated to different symphony orchestras, but they get together, you know, just to showcase themselves as the Korean symphony orchestra. And I have a lot of dreams. Every time I have to place, you know, my dreams go very far. When I was in Germany, I would talk to the Filipinos and I tell them that my dream would see the second generation Filipino German in the Bundestag or in Parliament. And they would look at me strangely and they thought I was the tooth fairy herself. But it's not a far away dream for us in Canada. We already tested it. So let us rear our second generation kids to have that kind of an aspiration so that we can do better, because possible for the most numbers. Leadership also requires a certain attitude. There are all sorts of models for leadership, servant leader model. But one thing is, we don't aspire for high office for personal glory, especially in organizations like this. There's always a body. And if we get together for a fundraiser, it's because we'd like to share. We have been very blessed in this country, and thank you very much on behalf of all of those who give your largest gift for the help that you give to our less important investment. So to the members, I want to give you your officers your fullest cooperation. Never lose sight of your motivation and vision, and keep your communication lines open among yourselves and also with us in the fortune. Congratulations to the recent officers, sir. And I commend the outgoing set of officers. I haven't met them yet, but I know that each new set of officers rides on the shoulders of those who came before me. I wish you all the warm buhay, good wishes, buhay tayo.
Enjoy the voice of a unique world culture while at the Centenarian culture of our adopted land, Canada. Yes, we have been enjoying learning among ourselves, but a happy aspect of this association is its being able to give assistance to all working businesses coming back in the old country, the Philippines. With this kind of endeavor, I am assuring the members of our organization that I'm willing to lead you through another 2 years. As you have just seen, our inducting officer saw to it that it be so. Thank you very much, and have a very good evening.
Thank you, Mr. Abel. Mr. Abel, by the way, is his third term as president of the SCAP. Thank you for a very, very good time. Not to mention also to Mr. Eddie, our advisor. Thank you for your kind support. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, you have seen over and above the dances of the kids and dance of the adults. At this time, may I present to you the choral group of the Eastern Summer Canadian Association.